so grateful that you're here tonight. Welcome to this recital. We appreciate your attendance on a cold January Saturday evening. So thanks for coming out. We're so grateful that this duo team is here. It's Sue Miller and Allison Bangerter, who are known as the Brava Piano Duo. And they live, and both of them teach in Twin Falls, and have been a duo team for 8 years. And I asked them what I could say about them by way of introduction, and they said, just tell them how much we enjoy working together and performing together. And I think that will be really obvious to all of you as you hear this program this evening. There will be a few announced changes that the team will announce. One announcement I would like to make about the change is there will be no intermission tonight. We just felt it would be a little better to not mingle at intermission, so there will be no intermission. It's a delightful program. Enjoy. And let's welcome Sue Miller and Allison Bangerter. Thank you.
said I could take my mask down to speak, but thank you so much for coming tonight. We appreciate you spending some time with us tonight and giving us a chance to perform this music. Aside from last week when we performed this program in Twin Falls, this is the first concert we've been able to do since before COVID, and we picked music that brought us peace, that made us happy, and that we had fun doing. So we hope that you will have some of those same emotions as we perform for you tonight. When two pianists sit at the same piano and play together, it's called a piano duet. When two pianists play together at their own separate pianos, it's called a piano duo. And we will be playing another piano duet tonight, and the remainder of our program will be piano duos. Johann Sebastian Bach is famous for his Brandenburg Concertos. And Concerto No. 3 is in G major, and he wrote that for three violins, three violas, three cellos, and a harpsichord. Tonight, we're going to do a wonderful transcription of this first movement of the Brandenburg Concerto No. 3, a transcription for piano duet. And it's done by a wonderful pianist, performer, and arranger of duo and duet piano music, Greg Anderson. If you're familiar with piano duo music and duets, this piano duo team, Anderson and Rowe, have just taken the stage, the duo piano stage by storm, and they're a wonderful group, and they, Greg arranges a lot of the music that they do, and so the one we just performed was arranged by him, and this next one is also arranged by him. When you play duets, you have to sit next to each other, and this duet that we'll be playing, the Brandenburg, is unlike any piano duet we have ever played. Usually you have one person sitting on the left and they play in the bass, and the other person sits on the right and they play in the treble. And maybe you noticed a little bit with this one we just played how we're kind of reaching over and around a little bit. But this next one has even more. There's times when I have to reach over here and she has to reach over here, and we are over and around and under to each other all the time. We have to be up and close personal to be able to play this piece. So I hope you enjoy watching our piano gymnastics as we perform the first movement of Bach's Brandenburg Concerto. Thank you.
most well known for his ballet music. So it's kind of fun that a couple of the pieces we're playing in the set are dances. The first one is a prelude, and then the second is a very sad waltz. That's what that title means. The third is a chanson or song, and then in the fourth you'll hear this repeating bass line, an ostinato, that happens over and over again throughout the whole piece. The fifth is a ballet, and then the sixth piece is a mazurka, which is a kind of Polish dance.
Thank you.
So George Gershwin was an American composer and pianist whose compositions are included in both popular and classical genres. He grew up in New York City and started piano when he was 10. His parents bought a piano for his older brother Ira, but George liked it the best. His first major work was Rhapsody in Blue, which established Gershwin's signature style of blending both classical and jazz idioms. At one point, George was asking to study composition with Maurice Ravel. And when Ravel found out how much Gershwin was making composing, and Gershwin was doing quite well, Ravel replied, "You should give me lessons." We will be playing four of Gershwin's most popular songs, which were performed on film and as a part of musicals, in the following order: "It's Wonderful, But Not For Me," "Someone to Watch Over Me," and "It Ain't Necessarily So."
Thank you.
19th Piano Concerto in F minor. Mozart wrote this piece for solo piano and orchestra in 1784. And then later, about almost 50 to 100 years, Ferruccio Busoni, an Italian composer, pianist, conductor, editor, writer, and teacher, refashioned the solo and orchestra version into a dialogue of equally matched entities and performed it for the first time 2 years later in Berlin. In this transcription, the two pianists have the opportunity to play all of the themes as a soloist and as the accompanist with a wonderful conversational exchange in the process.
Thank you.
He's a very talented composer and is also great friends with Robert and Clara Schumann. We will be performing the first five of the Brahms Hungarian dances. There's 21 that he wrote. The dance tunes are based on Hungarian themes. They were written in 1879. They're catchy and fun and were some of his most popular and lucrative works. They were written for piano duet first. In the 1880s, there was no Spotify. There was no radio. So if you wanted to hear the latest and greatest cool music by Brahms, you had to grab a piano duet, buddy, and go find a piano and play it. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.